Hey guys, it's Emily, and today's video is kind of unexpected. I was at Macy the other day, and I decided to pick up some stuff that I've been keeping my eye on. So I have here this little bag of goodies. I did buy some things that are a little bit pricey. I don't normally buy high-end makeup. A lot of my makeup is from the drugstores, but I have been starting to accumulate nicer makeup because I'm noticing that, of course, nicer makeup gives you a better look. I did use the stuff that I bought today on my face, and I think it came out pretty well, so let's see what I got. So the first thing was kind of something that I had already, but I just wanted more of. It's the Urban Decay eyeshadow palette in Blackout. I fell in love with this shade when I first got the Naked 2 palette. What I liked about it was the Naked 2 palette comes with a crease brush, and I started using this color as eyeliner. I would buy this shade in buckets if I could, like trays. I'm absolutely in love with this shade, and I know it's black and I know it's like dark. I actually use it today on my eyeliner. I don't know if you could see it. Eyeliner and foundation are the two things that I'm always trying to perfect. This to me gives the perfect eyeliner, whatever you want to call it, for me. These pods are around $20, and again, I do have it in the Naked 2 palette, but I thought, why do I keep using up the little small thing when I could just buy a tub of it and save the other ones for when I need to do like an eyeshadow. So the next two things I got were from Benefit Cosmetics. One was the Hello Flawless foundation in Honey, and the Benefit Boing Concealer shade 1. This I bought because I need to try a new foundation, because again, eyeliner and foundation are the two things that I'm always trying to perfect, because I have yet to find a foundation that I'm like, wow, I can use this every day. A lot of the foundations that I've been using have been from the drugstore, and I notice that they're very oily, and like after a couple of hours of wearing them, it leaves your face very like greasy and slimy, and nobody wants to feel like that. When I got home, I realized that I had a couple of free samples of this, so I've been using up the free samples before I opened this. The samples that I have are actually in like other shades, so I've been kind of experimenting with what I like on my face. And I did use a little bit of this one today, and again, I think it came out pretty well, so yeah. And then also, because I purchased two Benefit Cosmetic products, I did get a Benefit mascara called They Are Real, and the girl in the store said that this was a very good mascara. I have not tried this yet, but we'll see how it goes. Then I was very, very, very excited about this thing. I originally wanted a liquid to matte lipstick in a nude beige color. I've never had a liquid to matte lipstick before, and the girl in the store suggested that I try Tarte, which I hear only good things about. They didn't have any more of like the neutral color, so I did end up getting like a burgundy color, which I'm wearing on my lips right now. This color is called TBT Throwback Thursday, and I love it. I don't know if it's just the brand or the color or what, but I think it looks great on my lips. And ironically, I've been wanting to wear this shirt, and when I put on the lipstick, I was like, oh my god, it totally goes with the shirt I was gonna wear. So that was just a coincidence. I love this, and I will definitely be buying more shades of this. I'm also wanting to try Anastasia Beverly Hills and the Jeffree Star liquid to matte lipstick, because I also hear good things about those as well. So if those are any competition with this one, then good things are coming. So last but not least, I know a lot of people have been buying this because it's a somewhat newer item. It is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit in Gleam. I went to the store specifically looking for this, and I was nothing short of impressed. I do have the Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette, and that also was amazing. First off, what I love about this brand is all of the stuff comes in very sleek packaging, and it kind of makes it look very like classy and elegant. Then the other thing is, this stuff is pricey, but you get a lot for what you pay for. In the palette, there are four huge pods of color. There's Hard Candy, mimosa, starburst, and crushed pearl. Because there is 4 huge pods of color, you can also double these pods as contouring shades, blush, highlight, bronzer, like whatever you want to use it for. This kit, like, has multiple awesome, amazing uses. It was $40, but it comes with 4 huge pods. And if you were to buy, like, even in the drugstore, a nice blush palette, you'll be paying anywhere from $10 to $20 for that one color. So I think these 4 Anastasia Beverly Hills colors for $40 is a really good deal. And that is everything that I bought on my unexpected trip to Macy's. If you have a minute, click the subscribe button. I hope to see you guys very soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye!